One of South Auckland's top cops is calling it quits after 27 years on the country's toughest beat. Detective Senior Sergeant Neil Grimstone has solved every case he's worked on and tonight reveals exclusively to One News the real reason why he's going.
He's locked up countless crims on the toughest beat in the country. But now Neil Grimstone's closing the door for good on 27 years of policing.
It is a long time in one role, and I've ticked all the boxes I wanted to tick as a detective. And anything that I've got that's unsolved as such that I've worked on myself.
And from early beginnings,
we arranged for the various supermarkets to be searched.
Grim, as he's known to police, quickly became known for his colourful language.
I describe him as a mongrel dog. I've dealt with a lot of offenders in my time, but this guy took the cake.
This place has been the boil on the backside of the South Auckland Police for some time now. Now we've had a chance to lance that boil.
He's trying to tell me that he's changed and that he's found God. I don't know if God would be all that happy about that.
He's worked on the motorway overbridge killing, nabbed Mangere serial arsonist and even solved the case of a brutal rape where there was no offender.
It was the untruth that she was telling that was the truth for us. So, you know, that was a good result, albeit we didn't lock up a crook, we locked her up.
As a constable, he was in the thick of the 81 Springbok riots, but later his battles for justice became the low points of his career.
The judicial process where you might lose a case, you know, those sorts of things where you sort of think, well, why do I bother when you've lost something on a technicality in court?
Now he never plans on stepping foot in court again.
I certainly won't be lining up in the disaffected police officer's queue to give evidence against the police in any court proceedings because I'm a policeman through and through.
Grim leaves the police on Friday. He'll then lead a team at a private security firm.
Thank you very much.
Donna Marie Lever, One News.
Secondary school teachers have called off a strike planned for Wednesday. It follows talks between the PPTA and the Ministry of Education this morning. The teachers say negotiations will continue this week over their bid for a 7.5% pay increase.
Tuwharetoa Māori will now be able to charge commercial operators for using Lake Taupō. The tribe's been given the right to set up a licensing regime under a deal signed with the Crown tonight. It updates an agreement signed 15 years ago that gave Tuwharetoa ownership of the lake bed and includes a one-off payment of nearly $10 million.
Like any landowner, there will be discussion with the users of their property as Middle New Zealand enjoys in terms of ownership rights.
The tribe says the public will still be able to use the lake for free. Māori ancestral remains, which have been out of the country for more than 150 years, have been returned to Te Papa in Wellington. The remains, including a tattooed and preserved Māori head, were welcomed home at a ceremony this morning. They've been held by a Chicago museum for 49 years.
It is the first repatriation to Aotearoa from the continental United States. And what convinced us was that this was a request from the heart. It was a sincere and genuine request.
Te Papa will continue to research the tribal origins of the remains in the hope that they can eventually be returned to iwi.
America is now a real option for young Kiwis heading off on their OE. Washington's cutting some of its immigration and employment red tape for New Zealanders, but there's a catch.
Helen Clark probably wished this signing was to close a free trade agreement with our second biggest trading partner, America. But she's had to make do with a new deal for tertiary students aged 18 to 30. They can now travel and work in the US for a year.
They make it possible for our tertiary students to have a longer study and work period. So it's a big thrill to us that this has happened.
There was a real demand for it. We've never had problems with any abuse of visas, so you know, we were quite happy to do it.
Christopher Hill's one of the most influential people in Washington, and he hasn't come all this way just to talk about the big OE. He and around 100 other US and New Zealand government officials and business leaders are meeting behind closed doors for a three-day talkathon. And while they talk trade, renewable energy and sustainability inside, police and protesters clashed outside.
The US president can't negotiate free trade agreements without what's called fast track authority. That's expired, it's not likely to be renewed for a number of years. We are so far down the list that it's time people stopped fantasizing about a free trade deal.
I do believe it is desirable to achieve in the future an FTA, but at this point I can't tell you when precisely.
The new deal for students is a sign America and New Zealand are getting closer, but the critical free trade agreement remains as far away as ever. Tony Reid, One News.
Pakistan's former Prime Minister has returned home after 7 years in exile, prompting an immediate standoff. Nawaz Sharif refused to leave the plane after arriving at Islamabad airport following a dispute with immigration officials. He's now thought to have disembarked. Sharif wants to lead a campaign for democracy in his homeland.
1999 and the military's coup against Mr. Sharif. He had tried to sack the head of the army. Pakistan's Prime Minister was paraded in court, convicted of corruption and exiled. So his feud is personal with General Pervez Musharraf. Since the coup, the general has turned himself into a key ally of the West in its so-called war on terror. But now he's facing elections and is increasingly unpopular. Mr. Sharif believes the moment is ripe to strike back. The government is doing all it can to thwart his return. His party says hundreds of his supporters have been rounded up and arrested. Ahead of Mr. Sharif's return, security was being tightened all around Islamabad's airport. Police reinforcements brought in.
The opposition calls this a defining moment for Pakistan and their struggle to end dictatorship and military rule. Another former Prime Minister, Benazir Bhutto, is also planning to return from exile in the coming weeks. As his foes circle, General Musharraf's power is waning.
Israelis have been shocked by the discovery of a neo-Nazi gang suspected of vandalizing synagogues and carrying out a series of brutal attacks. The gang even documented its activities. The skinheads targeted foreign workers, drug addicts, homosexuals and religious Jews. They're all thought to be young immigrants from Russia with Jewish parents or grandparents. 8 have been arrested.
A pilot attempting an emergency landing in Denmark almost pulled it off unscathed until a last-second hitch. Moments after landing, the right wheel of the Scandinavian Airlines plane crumpled, tipping the aircraft over. All 73 passengers and 4 crew were evacuated before one of the engines caught fire. The pilot had opted for an emergency landing because of problems with the landing gear.